One thing I get when I get people coming here is that people say to me they've never seen slow worms or grass snakes, and we have quite a lot here, so I'm just going to try to video them. Problem being, of course, as soon as I uncover them, they don't like hanging around, so it'll maybe only a very quick glimpse of a grass snake if they're here. And of course they're not going to be today, just to ruin my plans of showing you something, because they hide under these logs I've cut ready for the fire, and this is roofing felt on the top to keep them dry, but they do like to hang under here. There's another spot up here where there has been a grass snake that's about 3 foot long lives under here, but I've uncovered it a couple of times to look at it and I think I've scared it, but we'll have another go. There. Which is good, because that's a grass snake there just moving with a white spot. So you've seen that. And there's a slow worm next to it, which is good. So there's both of them there, but that's only a baby grass snake. There is a big one under here. Here he goes, look. They are quite harmless. I ask people not to hurt them, because they're not doing any harm to anybody. And they eat the slugs and things, but they're only baby ones. So there's the slow worm, that one. And that's a grass snake next to it, but they're small. But anyway, just to show people the difference, but when a big one's under here, you can really see them. They're dark. There he goes, he's on the move. Anyway, let me cover them back up, because there he goes. So they're not hurting me, and I don't like to disturb them too much. So there you go. Slow worm's not bothered, because he's not moved. But I cover them up, because I don't want Daisy to disturb them. Anyway, there's a difference between a grass snake and a slow worm. Not very big ones, but at least I've shown it. So there we go. Let me see it. If I can do it again one day with the big ones, I will do. Anyway, that's all for now. Tight lines. Bye.